has actually been done in this entire area. Yeah. Let's quickly take a look at some of the work that has been done already in this area.
And I've been saying it since I was 21 years old, since I joined this industry. And when L'Oreal came to me and said that they're doing this, I was like, well, now I truly feel like I'm worth it. When I am associated with something that actually celebrates women who are impacting society in such a positive way, especially in India. And I think it's absolutely brilliant that we are doing this. And I'm so excited that you guys have decided to partner with us.
Right.
And the platform's just become larger. The show is going to be much larger. I feel these women need the recognition to get inspired to do better work. And I hope by giving, I honestly think awards give you validation. I feel I get very excited when I'm nominated or I get an award, no matter how, what the controversies are surrounding award giving and stuff like that. I get excited because I feel I get validation for the work I do.
Right.
And it also encourages me to work harder when somebody else gets the award.
So here's what we're going to do. And there is a difference and there's a change. So
yes.
The jury has been working on finalizing the nominees all morning.
Yes.
And there's a surprise.
What?
You have no idea who the nominees
are.
No,
I don't know.
I have no idea who the
nominees
are.
This is the first time. This is the fifth year. They've not told me.
So what we're doing is we're going to be inviting up the jury right now.
Yes.
And they are going to be telling us the nominees in real time, as they were. And we'll find out. And then let's try and educate ourselves also
about
as to each of the nominees and why they were actually nominated.
And before you go ahead with calling the jury members, I would like to also talk about the categories before they come in and educate us on who the nominees are. I'm very excited to know who they are. So we have 8 categories, and there'll be 4 nominees.
Yeah.
The categories are social impact, women who have made breakthrough interventions in grassroots development, education, women who have strengthened our education system with new ideas, engaging techniques, and learning networks. This is very close to my heart, by the way.
Yeah.
The originals, which is science and innovation, then game changers, business and entrepreneurship,
then the
eco-revolutionists, there's environment, there's literature, there's art, there's sports.
That's it.
That's brilliant. So I think I'm very excited about knowing who these amazing women are.
Yeah.
Right, so let's start. Let's kick off straight away by calling the jury onto the stage. So let me start by calling Belinda Wright, Executive Director, Wildlife Protection Society of India. Belinda, be working with us. Come, Belinda, grab a seat. I'll call all of you one by one. Shobhna Narayan. Shobhna Narayan, Kathak Dancers, Padma Shri Awardee, Ranjana Kumari, Center for Social Research and President Women Power Connect, Dr. Pinky Anand, who's the Additional Solicitor General of India, and Mr. Saurabh Srivastav, co-founder of the Indian Angel Network and NASSCOM, also just got the Padma Shri, so many congratulations. Please take a seat. Hang on, please.
I wore my lenses so I could actually immediately read where I was supposed to sit. I started wearing lenses.
Shobhna, that's yours, yeah. Hi, Shobhna. Come. All right, and a special pleasure to invite, to also welcome, joining us from Pune, another one of our jury members, Anu Aga, Director of Thermax Limited, philanthropist, Member of Parliament, Padma Shri Awardee. So, ma'am, why don't I start with you? Thank you so much. It's been so kind of you to take some time out to join us at the jury meet, even though you couldn't be with us here. Just wanted to get your take on some of the factors, your overall experience, the nominees. One thing that perhaps strikes you about all of them.
Sorry, what is the question?
I was just asking you that the nomination process that you had today, anything that particularly caught your eye or your attention during this process?
Well, I felt we were trying to find women who have not been in the media glare and yet have done excellent work. So this was our idea of recognizing outstanding work done by ordinary people.
Okay.
Ma'am, one more question. I know you have to leave us, so I'll just ask you one more question and you know, before you go. Do you think you're starting to see a major change in the last few years that the number of women who are now feeling empowered to come out and start making a difference to the lives of others in the community, is that something which is really on the upswing?
I think women have made an impact for many years, but it's getting the media's attention far more these days, which is a wonderful thing.
I absolutely agree.
Okay. And you've also done a lot of work in empowering women, so any final thoughts you want to leave us with before you go?
I think I personally feel we shouldn't make much difference between the genders, but because women are not getting the attention they ought to, a little push by having these awards is important. And they also act as role models for others to succeed.
All right, ma'am. Well, thank you so much. It's been a pleasure having you with us. If you have to, I know you have to leave us shortly, so thank you so much, ma'am, for having joined us. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ms. Anand, I have a question for you. How was your experience at the jury meet? I heard it was very entertaining as well, and I heard it's very, Manashi said it was very solid, a lot of debate, and it was intelligent conversation. And how was it? How did you go about selecting the nominees?
I think we had a very clear direction, and of course the process itself was entertaining and inspiring, in fact, because all the participants were actively participating to find the best out of the best. So that made it really tough. The nominees were absolutely amazing. Each of them, I mean, we had a tough choice, but we tried to get together to kind of innovate. But coming to the, you know, subject of what really we were reaching out for, I think the whole criteria was people who have achieved cross-section of people and innovation. I think, in fact, subsequently we'll find out, but I think science and technology, the categories, science and innovation, entrepreneurship, sports, some of these were the most outstanding categories of people that we came across. And I'm delighted at the categorization itself, which you people obviously made. And the fact that, of course, Vikram and you are there would make it most inspiring to everybody. The idea is to make it an outreach for a cross-section of the people. And this is not only for women, for men and women. Achievement is the hallmark of today.
Just out of curiosity, I wonder if it was a peaceful process or
was
there some big fighting?
I heard it was a very enthusiastic discussion. That's all I was saying.
Enthusiastic, or was it a bit more? Was there a big fight, Belinda? Tell us the truth.
At one stage, I did threaten to have sort of fisticuffs.
Fisticuffs.
No, we were talking about physical.
Oh. Ranjana has almost threatened to punch somebody once in a big fight. Sonam, this is inside information.
Well, you know, it was tough because they were 14-year-old nominated. I mean, can you imagine a 14-year-old innovator? And then we had this very famous scientist. So it was really a kind of range from where we had to choose women. And it is very important to see how very obese became an entrepreneur and started owning hotels. Amazing. I think discovery is really, really very something inspiring. Which is very, very inspiring, the way you have found these women. And then it wasn't difficult, but certainly we had some area of disagreements and they managed to, you know, agree at the end.
What is very interesting, ma'am, is you said that there's science and innovation and sports, and you specifically spoke about those categories. And unfortunately, we associate certain categories or certain things with only men who are. So I think it's very exciting that we're awarding women in science and innovation and in sports. I think, you know, we are very talented women. I think we should totally run the world, according to me. And I'm very excited that you actually brought those up. And, you know, with L'Oreal, and we've been trying to actually encourage women in all vocations, you know, and I think that's really cool.
Manshi? We have to be generous as well. We allow two male judges.
Yeah, I was saying, who's the second male judge? So I was about to ask you, Mr. Srivastava, there wasn't gender equality on the jury. So as the one man out there, how was that experience?
Well, I can tell you, sitting there, I could understand how women feel in Indian corporate boardrooms.
Oh, that's lovely.
That's a very good point. Manshi?
We had a discussion on the boys' club and the fact that the boys' club exists everywhere, whether it's in India or across the world. So I think he, you know, Dr. Shivastav must have found it very amusing, but he did agree with us. Yeah.
It's very true because suddenly it's a very different environment. So you feel that, but I must tell you, I was mostly hurt.
But all right. Of course, you had Pranoy for some company, even though long distance. And as Pranoy must have perhaps informed you, we are used to the way it feels in NDTV because NDTV is a vastly... Those of us who are men are in a very small...
It's very strange, but it's true in the media. I've noticed it's mostly women.
Yes.
And which is amazing. And that's, I think that's why the media likes me, you know.
Absolutely.
They're all clapping. Okay, no, it's right. A fact.
But I think it's also very good that you had categories where exactly like Sonam was saying, where women excelling is not usually celebrated in business and entrepreneurship. It's happening more and more now. So I'm very happy that that category was in there.
So should we...
What is most important for us is that it should not be categorized only as a women issue or a women's section or a women's selection. I mean, these people are achievers. It's just a coincidence they are women, and they have made it, as you'll see in the course of description of these people.
So, ma'am, what would you like to add?
I would say that a lot of these women have made their mark in a, which is commonly perceived as a male domain. And a lot of them have really come forward and have made such, incredible achievements and incredible work that they've done. Be it in the field of boxing or be it this or that, of course, we always associate entrepreneurship, and that kind of economic mindset. It's usually traditionally ascribed to a male thing. But here again, we found that amazing kind of women who have come and punctured male domain in all respects.
Which is awesome.
So should we kick off, Sonam? I'm sure you're curious to know who the nominees are.
I'm dying to know who the nominees are. This is the first year, I think, where they've not told me. I don't know why they've kept me in suspense.
Because
it's really upsetting me.
We want to get your reaction.
I know.
You know, we want to surprise you. So yeah. Now it's here the surprise. So Pinky, why don't we start with you?
Yeah.
So Dr. Pinky Anand, the nominees in the category of science.
I think I like the category of the originals, which is a categorization of a larger sphere of science and innovation. Women scientists and innovators whose breakthroughs have created a new world order for us. And the nominees are Dr. Tessie Thomas, who is the project director for Agni, Lalita Prasidha, who has again done a lot of work in the innovation of biotechnology, Nina Tandon, who's again a biotechnologist who's done work on bone density and other kind of performances, Himani Kalucha, who is a young girl who has done a new work on water purifier. So each of them you spread across the spectrum of young to old and old to young, across the spectrum of activity.
All right, if you could have those names back, I just want to get anybody who'd like to give us more details about each of them and what particularly struck your eye about them.
I was just talking to Manashi about bone density. And if you don't mind repeating the name of...
Nina Tandon.
I think it's quite amazing because I know as Indian women, we have a huge issue with... we have a lot of bone... We have problems with osteoporosis and arthritis and bone density is a huge issue.
And issues also.
Issues and everything. It's we don't absorb, I don't know why I'm going to the science of it, but we don't absorb vitamin D as well.
Science is because we are, as women, a little more malnourished because we don't take care of ourselves first, but of the family. So.
Apparently, it's also genetic. So I think it's very cool because it's actually specific to Indian women. I know this because my mother and my grandmother and... Most probably, I will also suffer from it after a certain age. And I think it's quite cool that there's a woman only, innovating it, because a woman only will understand another woman's problem, right?
And this is degeneration of bone cells.
Which is amazing.
With your own bone cells.
Right. Yeah. What about Dr. Tessie Thomas, missile scientist?
Oh, wow.
Yes,
I want to talk about her because this is one area where women have not really dared to enter and they have not excelled. But look at her achievements. And someone who's so simple, someone who's just, you know, in an image of a mother, if you see her, she's so simple, she just is another Indian woman from household. But the scientist of the caliber that is globally recognized, I think this is somebody, we really salute her for doing what she did to Indian science in terms of missile technology.
Okay.
She is the missile woman of India.
Okay. I believe when the Agni experiment took off,
yes,
then you had women in Kanjivaram sarees along with Dr. Tessa Thomas who were actually keeping everything alive.
Yeah.
All right. Anything to say on the other nominees?
Lalita Prasidha, she has...
She's
14. And wow, she has developed a water purifier. In fact, she was a subject matter of a lot of discussion because, you know, considering the question was, when you give award, should it be to people who achieved it, who've actually delivered, or people who've come up with something new? And this was the innovation that was acknowledged for a girl of such a young age, and hopefully she will make
water
many more.
Water purifier from corn cobs. So
water purifier from?
Corn cobs. So, and so therefore it's a model that is, that can be scalable in many parts of the world. So, you know.
I think the only concern we had is awarding her at this age, are we just raising expectations to a point where it'll be very hard for her?
All right. 14 years old, were you making water purifiers?
When I was 14, I was piercing my tongue. So
I was
rebelling. I was being an artist, I think.
All right, that's absolutely fantastic. So those are the nominees in the field of science and innovation, the originals. Ma'am Shobhana Narayan, would you tell us the nominees in the field of arts?
Well, first of all, I would like to mention that it was wonderful to see all the women, you know, who were shortlisted. And each one of them in the field, they have done fantastic amount of work in the field of arts and crafts. And what was important that they concentrated on revivalism. They were also concentrating on the upkeep of tradition. But it wasn't only just upkeep of tradition, but they were making actually new adaptations. And therefore, they were also empowering the people and the public. And in this category, again, we had a fantastic array. And finally, the winners, you know, what we selected were Sri Jatha Roy. She is, her artwork speaks. It is not that, you know, there is a message. And in fact, one of her artworks was quite interesting, that there was a lot of, she showed women sitting at a chai shop and having chai. Normally, if you go to a chai dhaba wala, you have yes, exactly. So you only see men. So here it is, she's again giving a social message. Then you have there Anita Singh, who's an excellent photographer and of all genres in photography. Then you had Neha Kirpal. Now Neha Kirpal was an amazing person because she does this art fair and where she has brought art to the people and at the same time people to the art. And so she's done an amazing amount of work in bridging the two, art as well as the people. And then we have Kalki Subramaniam. Kalki Subramaniam is somebody unique, a transgender. And this transgender who has gone into the field of acting, who has also, you know, supporting their education of other transgenders, who has started painting also. And so this kind of a person who has been doing so much through the work of art as an artist herself and as well as then empowering others and training others, there was quite a bit.
Anything to add on any of them by the nominees?
Sonam? I'm quite, you know, for me, since I believe that I'm an artist, as an actor. I just...
Everybody